As prices of basic goods remain high, a labor umbrella organization files a petition seeking a 530 peso increase in the daily minimum wage in the National Capital Region. Zen Hernandez reports.
Government data show there are 6.65 million underemployed Filipinos in January as the country continues to reel from high inflation. This is a real and present problem to many workers, including Ramil Radam, a forklift operator who is neck deep in loans in order to provide for the daily needs of his family.
Mahirap po talaga. Lalo nung umupahan ka, tatlong pinapag-aaral ko. Yung sahod ko na yun na 570, kulang pa yun.
On Tuesday, an umbrella group of more than 20 labor organizations trooped to the NCR National Wages and Productivity Commission office in Manila to file a wage hike petition for a 530 peso increase to the daily minimum wage. According to the Unity for Wage Increase Now, or UIN, there is an urgent need to hike salaries to attain a living wage for workers' families.
Nagtaas yung presyo ng onang pamasahe, no? At yung nakambang pagtaas pa ng pasahe sa LRT-MRT, yung pagtaas ng kuryente, pagtaas ng singil sa tubig. Magpatawag sila ng public hearing para maidepensahan din namin yung bakit 530.
Non-profit research, education, and information development group Ibon Foundation previously said the real value of the current 570 peso daily minimum wage in the NCR has been significantly eroded due to the steep and fast rise in prices of commodities and services. The group also said that to afford basic needs, a family of five living in Metro Manila must earn at least 1,119 pesos daily. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines admits inflation is making life harder for Filipinos. But they also pointed out that a mere 8 million out of almost 50 million workers in the country benefit from minimum wage increases. They also reminded that many businesses have yet to recover from the pandemic and that investors are discouraged by wage rates in the Philippines, which is why they are also counting on the national government to provide solutions.
Nung araw kasi, pinakamababa yung minimum wage sa atin dito. Ngayon, nalampasan na natin everybody. I think second na dito sa ASEAN. Mas mataas ang sweldo natin, pero mas mataas ang presyo ng pagkain natin sa fuel. Yun ang problema. So we didn't have to solve the problem of the cost of fuel and the cost of commodities.
The Labor Department said wage hike petitions have been filed as well in Region 6 and 7 and that deliberation is up to the regional wage boards. But the department believes wage alone is not the problem, but also the quality of jobs in the country, which is why the focus is currently on job creation in key industries.
Nakikita pa rin natin yung pangangailangan na magtuon tayo ng pansin sa manufacturing sector kasi nariyan yung medyo pang matagalan na trabaho, no? Mas magandang benepisyo. Siyempre, nariyan yung IT and business process management sector na sa aming dialogo sa kanila, meron silang potential na sinabing paglikha ng malaking bilang ng employment.
The Labor Department believes there is a need to focus on training and upskilling to help workers secure better paying positions. The department hopes to offer higher quality jobs in its job fair on May 1, Labor Day, while labor groups are gearing up for a massive protest. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Energy Department is confident there will be no rotational blackouts this summer. And as Alvin El Chico tells us, power plant operators are assuring the public they are doing what they can to avoid plant outages.
After hearing reports that there might be tightness in electricity supply for Luzon this dry season, this coffee shop owner is planning to buy a generator set. The problem is, he did not allot money for it.
Nasanay tayo na ang kuryente natin eh, hindi naman nagkakaroon ng interruption. So hindi na namin siya isinama doon sa budget. Pero yun nga, kung sakali mang palaging mangyayari yung ganong situation, kailanganin na rin namin isama sa budget, pero kailangan mapag-isipang mabuti kung kasya.
The cheapest 1,000 watts genset costs about 5,000 pesos, but it can only be used for lighting fixtures. The more expensive ones, which can power air cons and other appliances, range from 70,000 pesos to more than 100,000 pesos.
Marami po siyang nag-e-enquire, pero inaano lang po nila yung mga price. Kung magkano kasi po, medyo may kataasan po talaga yung price ng generator, lalo na po pag silent type.
In its latest forecast, the Energy Department says there's no power outage projection, but the situation will be different once a power plant unexpectedly bogs down.
It is for the private sector to make it a reality. Kapag ka mayroong generator na hindi sumunod sa usapan natin ng GOMP kung kailan sila mag-maintenance, magkakaproblema tayo.
The other option will also hurt consumers.
Pagka may bumagsak na planta na mas mura, paandarin natin yung mas mahal. Ibig sabihin nun, tataas yung konti ang presyo ng kuryente.
Power producers admit there are not enough power plants to sufficiently cover rising demand, especially during the hotter months of the year.
Ang init-init. So the consumption, obviously, the demand will obviously go up. And right now, I can assure you that my member generators are talking to each other to make sure that yun, lahat sila tumatakbo. Yung mga dapat tumakbo nung summer, tatakbo.
The group wants to eventually remove or, in the meantime, increase the secondary price cap in the electricity spot market. The more than 6 peso per kilowatt hour secondary price cap is triggered once spot prices breach the 9 peso per kilowatt hour level for 3 straight days.
If we remove that and then you allow people to build and people to compete, then the market will behave naturally. Panandalian lang naman yung sakit na mararamdaman mo tataas ang presyo. Pero pagkatapos nun, like anything in life, hihina rin yan eh.
The chairperson of the Energy Regulatory Commission sees the point of the power generators.
In the short term, oo, nakikinabang tayo kasi mababa siya. Pero in the long term, pag walang pumapasok dito, doon na natin mararamdaman, brownout ang kapalit. Tutulungan nyo kaming magpaliwanag na para to sa ikabubuti nating lahat.
The ERC is set to rule on the request of power generators by third quarter of 2023. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
So officials of a local storage facility are cited in contempt for failing to attend a House panel probe on possible price manipulation and hoarding of onions. The two, both from the firm Super 5 Cold Storage, will be detained at the House of Representatives for 10 days. Several show cause orders have also been issued against other personalities for not showing up at the hearing of the House Committee on Agriculture and Food. Many of them had cited medical reasons for their absence. Now, during the hearing, lawmakers alleged some traders, private custom brokers, cold storage facility owners, and pipe forwarders are in collusion to manipulate prices of agricultural products.
Dami may sakit. I don't want to prejudge. Being the chair, ayoko naman prejudge, but we will accord them the chance to explain the pandemic happening at this stage.
The first underwater images of the sunken MT Princess Empress have come to light. The vessel was located Tuesday as the Justice Department builds up its case against the tanker's owner. Dennis Latour reports.
A day after it was launched into the sea, the Japanese Remotely Operated Vehicle, or ROV, has released initial images of the sunken MT Princess Empress. The oil tanker was located at around 400 meters deep, consistent with the earlier findings of the National Mapping and Resource Information Authority. The ROV also took videos of several parts of the tanker. However, the photos and videos are not enough to determine the damage sustained by the vessel and whether the cargo it is carrying has begun leaking. It will take up to 5 days before experts can release results of their findings. This development sparked optimism among the incident management team that the crisis, which is now on its third week, will soon come to an end.
We are combating something that we haven't seen, no, all throughout for 21 days. And right now, there's something. We have an information. We now have an eye underneath incident area. It's very important.
Magiging basis ito ng next steps natin sa pakikipag-ugnayan ka rin kay Harbor Star. Nagkakaroon na sila din ng initial ano, na mga rekomendasyon ng mga equipment na kailangan gawin, na kailangan gamitin, at kung kinakailangan ito ay ibiyahin na.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla on Tuesday visited Pola with some representatives from the National Bureau of Investigation. Remulla said all oil spill affected areas can be considered as crime scenes. The secretary also said that DOJ is building up the cases that they will file against the owners of MT Princess Empress, as well as some members of the Philippine Coast Guard and Marina for allegedly failing to fulfill their duties. The DOJ is considering filing of administrative, civil, and criminal charges against the ship owner, RDC Real Marine Services.
Bukod po yan sa, ano, sa value ng Verde Island passage that can really be damaged, which is being damaged right now by this oil spill. Alam niyo naman, ang Verde Island Passage is one of the most sensitive environmental areas in the world. Kaya isa po yan sa nag-raise ng concern ng Department of Justice.
The Department of Justice also encouraged Fisher Folk to file a writ of kalikasan against the ship owner and its insurance company. According to the DOJ, before becoming a tanker, it was a scrap vessel and used for 5 years. But Remulla declined to identify who commissioned the transport of the 800,000 liters of industrial fuel aboard the ill-fated ship.
We're securing all the documents. Alam nyo, hindi po yan ang priority namin. Priority namin, iayos po yung mali. Hindi ho kami turo ng turo sa tao na wala ho kami ginagawa.
May pinagtatakpan ba na malaking tao?
Wala po. Hindi ho namin gawain yan.
In the meantime, the fishing ban on areas affected by the Oriental Mindoro oil spill stays. Oriental Mindoro Governor Romelito Durol says they decided to keep the ban because any potential catch will not be safe for consumption.
Ayon na rin po sa rekomendasyon ng DAB FAR, hindi pa po safe ito for human consumption kasi nag-accumulate po yung contamination sa flesh ng marine products, ano, ng mga marine life at mga bagay na kinukonsume ng tao.
Meanwhile, a marine expert who is also a DOJ consultant believes the sunken ship is not carrying industrial fuel but material used in producing asphalt.
I know immediately, by experience, this is it. It will be used to make asphalt or for roads.
Hindi siya.
Sa Mag-Adam. Hindi siya diesel.
We need to verify that, kaya kumuha rin ako ng sample.
The Philippine Coast Guard Batangas has confirmed that the oil spill has reached the villages of Corona and San Isidro in Tingloy Island, which is part of the Verde Island Passage, considered as the global epicenter of marine biodiversity. Some environmental groups say they are ready to help in the restoration of mangroves affected by the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. There is Datu, ABS-CBN News, Oriental Mindoro.
The number of people who have gotten sick from the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro has climbed to nearly 200. Of that number, 58% showed respiratory symptoms, 23% experienced neurological illness, while 14% showed gastro-related symptoms. A local health official says the department has sent water samples for testing.
Tinest na po ng DOH, nagsagawa po ng water testing noong March 8 and March 9. Nakapag-submit na po tayo ng 31 na samples for BTEX or dun sa physical and chemical testing. As preventive measure na po, even without the result of the water testing yet, ay nagbigay na po siya ng libreng supply ng tubig nung naunang mga araw pa lamang. At yung mga communities na oil spill affected na kumukuha ng source ng drinking water sa deep well, shallow tube wells, ay sinuplayan po ng provincial government ng tubig.